Hi, welcome to this video tutorial. We're going to make a video about how to make an ISO, how to burn an ISO to the USB, and this time we're on Mac. So these have been created already for Linux and for Windows, and what's left is here for Mac. So we're gonna follow this link, unetbootin, GitHub, and let's see if we can download. We can also try other Windows or Linux or Mac, but of course let's try this one now. It's down here in downloads. He's downloading it. This is the ArchMerge that's already ready, so I went to the SourceForge website. That's what you'll have to do later on. There's this link up here, download now SourceForge, and then you follow the link. And there will be two different elements. There will be a bare ISO that's going to be launched the 1st November 2017. And there's going to be a full one, which is a full version, but we'll just call it ArchMerge. And that's going to be released the 1st October. So you download the ISO from there. That's one thing. Then you have this new application that's here. It's a disk image that you have, DMG. Just double click it and wait, and then you'll get some information what you need to do. Not in this case, so you can either double click it right now, or we can keep it for later applications. So we have here this folder programs, and we can just drop it in here, and then it's gonna copy paste from this DMG till here. That means that when we go like this, we'll see it pop up somewhere. Here it is, unetbootin, and there you can run it. So we don't need this one anymore. It's not known, the application is not known, and security measures are in place, and blah blah. So how do you circumvent that? We go to this place, so it's all in Dutch here, but it's no problem. It's always the same. It's up here, system preferences, probably something like that. Security, little house, it's always the same. And where is the GEM? Here. Allow programs to be downloaded with, and then you have to tell them that, look guy, it's okay. So for this one, say okay, this is okay. And now we can run it again. So, well, yeah, we need to click on it now here. And we say, okay, open it. So sometimes we get this pop-up things. It's some kind of security that Mac has to be sure that nothing bad happens to your system. But in this case, we do need to run this. So, well, first of all, you can download a lot of things straight from the thing. Never tried that. I really don't do that. I go to the website of the developers and download it there. But I always use this one, disk image, floppy. No, I don't think so. And then I'm gonna look, where is my ISO? Yep, waiting for the pop-up. There it is. Long time to what downloads. This is the 6th version. Could be a bit smaller, please. We are making a tutorial. This one, open. And all the rest USB, I popped in the USB, as you can see, that's this one. So do check that's okay, USB drive, so you don't overwrite anything else. And then you say okay, and it's gonna say, look, yes to all, otherwise I can't continue. Yes to all, and we're going ahead with the extraction from the source and destination. 102 files, but I think the best thing now is to pause the tutorial if I can find the button. Everything became here a little white. Okay, pause recording. And there we are, the installation is complete. Current, the created USB will not boot off a Mac, insert into a PC and select USB option in the BIOS. That's quite clear. So, okay, there you go. We have now this new USB. Everything has been copy-pasted on it, and you can start running our system. Let's clean it up here. We can click here on Mac like this. So that's gone, and this goes into the bucket, how you say that here. Underneath, you don't see it in the tutorial, but have this little bucket. You put it in there, and then it's gone. It's gone. It's out of, you've ejected the USB. That's how you do it in Mac. And that's that. Everything is clean. The download folder maybe needed some cleaning here. We don't need this anymore. So Command Backspace and gone. All right. Have fun.